Hey guys, Bolt here with the quickest entertainment I can give you. We're back with Evil Within the Consequence. I think we're about to get a boss battle or a runaway scene. Because we just saved Leslie from Ruvik's control. We got one of the scrap pieces. We met Laura. I think that was the first time we seen Laura in this, the two-part DLC. And then we are right after Joseph just got shot, so we're getting very close to the end of the game. I think there's two or three chapters in this one, so let's get this done. We're in Beacon. The fact that we're by Beacon means we're very close to the end. Yeah, we gotta be very close.
Oh shit. He's too far gone. I've gotta stop him.
I don't wanna use the gun here. Because we do need to save a bullet for the brain Easter egg. Wait, what? Okay, that was pretty easy. All right.
Answer our questions. What are you afraid of? What could haunt you so?
He's an annoyance, like one of the worst bosses. All right, actually, we gotta be careful because one of these, I think it's close to this one, there's a snail. There's something here.
But why Leslie? What makes him special? Leslie was not always like this. He became catatonic after a traumatic experience as a child. His family was murdered in front of him. The data would suggest that brainwave synchronization with Ruben correlates to specific trauma. In this case, Ruben's own loss of family.
This will not do. We need something
Is there like a special thing here? We're getting like the core ideals of what they're doing, but got a little voice recorder there. The doctor's story isn't that easy, hard to find out. It's just he made a bad deal thinking he can become very important, and that's not how secret governments normally work. Oh, a snail! Wow! Oh, zombified Sebastian, that's cool.
We need some rational insights, Stan. Potentially that person could neutralize Rubin. I mean, Rubik. With my knowledge of the system, I may be of some.
Absolutely not. We can't afford you complicating this any further. We will prepare one of our own.
Sending someone inexperienced, we can't even be sure they can come back.
It will need to be someone expendable.
Okay. Cool.
And I trust in you.
Don't trust a secret government. That is just how you should always see things. Was I not just supposed to come in here, period, or something? Because this is a weird room to allow me to come in and out of. So that's the model of the... So I'm supposed to do something here. Is there another memory that's supposed to trigger here? Is that what we're talking? Did I not? Trigger something? I'm doing something wrong. Come on. One second, guys. I am attempting to find something real quick. Because it's not giving me a direction here. I think I was supposed to stick around to see what that person's doing. Markiplier! Always the one that tells me where to go. Okay. There's the part about the key card. I know. Come on. Oh, did I miss something? Oh, there was a snail in the freaking elevator. That sucks. It has young Sebastian and Joseph. That's... aw. That sucks. There's the beginning of this. There is that. Okay. Okay, so it looks like you're supposed to trigger this table. Yep. That doesn't help. So I'm supposed to find the control for this, I'm guessing? Butcher? Why am I at the butcher's? Okay, we have a... Okay, I'm trying to figure out. So this is normally a 4x4. There's a bunch of chainsaws. This window's a 4x4. Right? That's a very bad... I know that's where the puzzle is supposed to be for. But... what's bad about this is... it's broken glass. That's what they're trying to use here. And it doesn't really do anything. Wait a minute. Is this just a puzzle where you're supposed to, like, highlight everything? Is that what this was? Oh, no, it's a selective puzzle. Okay. This isn't one of those. All right. Yeah, like I said, it's kind of horrible how you tell this. So it looks like the entire top row. I don't. I think everything but like the bottom two and the top. Okay. This is frustrating. There we go. So three corners, the third top row, and then okay. All right, well, that throws my window theory out of the way. Well, I did all that investigating for nothing. Well, that kind of explains how he was able to see Sebastian there. He was probably in that little back area. Oh, it has no bullets, so I couldn't even use it before. I know the chainsaw guy is still alive because he was in the very last chapters, but... I actually get to see the extent of this, okay. Cool. That's not cool. This is a very... This is a very generic area, because I'm pretty sure there was a couch in this kind of area before. In, like, the first part of this. Ah, come on. We have about 10 more minutes. Well, that's a shotgun for sure. Oh, I still got one. Okay. Oh, that's cool. Shotgun! It's a... That's nice, but... Something over here. Oh, a bottle. That won't help much. Oh, bitch. I don't have that much ammo. What? Back to it, like normal. Okay, give me back my running. Give me some bolts, maybe? No? Okay. That was just a get away kind of thing. Oh! That's not good. Okay. So checking that cart was gonna be a trap. Thank you. that's nice of you. What? Oh, God. The Ruvik clones. Come on. Let me get my speed back. I wouldn't say that. There's a small percentage of them actually messing around in here. Oh wait. We had a find the puzzle kind of issue, or. Alright, well, it looks like we're at another checkpoint. Well, actually, hold up. I'll get that file and then I'll save and then we'll be done. I gotta go make some Halo Reach videos before it gets too much later. Oh, okay, cool. I got all the personal files. Cool. So anyways, I think that'll be it. So I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.